there, Alley Cats! Today's video is very special because thanks to you awesome people, my channel has hit 6,000 subscribers. So thank you all so much. I appreciate every last one of you. And to celebrate this milestone, I will be doing another video that I've gotten a lot of requests for, which is a Q&A, since my last one was a really, really long time ago. So I posted on Twitter and on the Hypixel forums that I was doing a Q&A and began gathering questions, and you guys did not disappoint. There are some really good ones here, and I'm sorry if you asked a question and it didn't make it into this video, but I already have so many questions to answer in this one video, and I don't want it to drag on forever, so we're gonna go ahead and get right into this. If you had $1 million, what would you do with it? Well, unfortunately, my answer is probably going to be rather boring, since I wouldn't blow it on expensive jewelry or fancy clothing or anything. The first thing I'd probably do is buy new cars for myself and my boyfriend, since our current vehicles are rather old and not in the best shape. I would also pay off the mortgage on our house and move to a better house, preferably not in the desert, since it gets ridiculously hot here in Arizona. Doesn't need to be like a mansion or anything, just something we could live in comfortably for at least a really long time that could suit a family whenever we start having kids. We'd also probably take a vacation somewhere, but I think for the most part, that's it. Maybe buy a couple video games and furniture that's been on my wish list of things to get for like a year. But any leftover money, I'd probably just save it. Kind of a boring adult answer, but there you go. What have you done voice acting for? I haven't done any major voice acting work, mostly small works here and there, including a school project game developed by the Hypixel mod Gerber, which I've been meaning to record on my channel for forever, since that was years ago. But maybe I'll get to it one of these days. I was also supposed to do some extra voice work for an upcoming game called Yandere Simulator, which probably at least some of you have heard of since it's gotten quite a big following. It's a much bigger project that's still in development, so I haven't recorded any lines yet, but the developer said he really liked the reel I sent in and will contact me again once the game is farther along and ready for more in-depth voice work. Though, with the large amount of controversy that's been coming out in recent months about the developer, I'm not entirely sure I'll still be doing that, but we'll see. Why do you have a scary forum profile picture? Because it's a drawing of my Minecraft skin, and I just like it. I might change it eventually, but I think it's a really excellent drawing, so whatever I change it to would have to be even better. What is your build battle score and title? My current score as of right now is 3,760, and I have the trained title. Being a filthy casual, I do quite a bit of build battle. Would you rather time travel to the past or the future? And definitely the future, just because in the past they didn't have as much medical knowledge, so it was more likely to get sick or die at an early age. And I'd like to think that farther into the future it will be even better, and there will be more advancements to improve or extend the human lifespan. And just the thought of future things and the unknown of what could happen then, it fascinates me. It would be interesting. Are you single? Nope. As I mentioned, I do have a boyfriend. His name is Ben, and as of when this video goes up, we will be together exactly 2 years and 9 days, meaning our anniversary was a couple weekends ago, and he's even been in some of my videos like Stardew Valley and Doki Doki Literature Club, so you'll probably see him some more on my channel in the future. Do you have any consoles? Yes, I do. I have every console still from when I was younger, which is a GameCube and a PlayStation 2 and 3. Hoping to get a PlayStation 4 soon, and we also have an original Xbox, a 360, and an Xbox One that belongs to my boyfriend. And somehow everything still works, which is amazing. If you could have any superpower, what would it be and why? Definitely the power to fly, because not only would it be much easier than driving and negate the need for a car, which would save a lot of money, but I also have a massive fear of heights, so not having to worry about the fall would really help me to get over that. What advice as a former mod in your position would you give to someone applying for staff? I've gotten this question several times, and I'm honestly very flattered that people would come to me for advice. So I guess the first thing I'd say, of course, to anyone wishing to become staff on Hypixel is know what you're getting yourself into. I've talked about some of the problems of the current staff team, and of course, on the surface, everything may seem fine and dandy and sunshine and rainbows, but there's still definitely some very persisting issues. That being said, if you actually want to become staff for the right reasons and actually want to help the server rather than just get a fancy tag and something you can brag about to your friends, then hopefully those issues won't affect you as much. There are some really good staff members who will gladly accept you to the team and help you, so don't be afraid to ask questions, because it's certainly better than doing something you shouldn't or messing up and getting an instant demotion like I and many others have. How much time do you spend on the Hypixel server and forums? Right now, I don't spend a lot of time on the server unless I'm recording or playing with some friends, maybe a few times a week at most, but I definitely spend a lot more time on the forums since I can just scroll through on my phone during downtime at work or something. What did you study / are you studying in college? Well, I'm no longer in college. I'm planning to hopefully go back eventually to at least finish my associate's degree for teaching English, since that's what I was studying, but I guess in the meantime, you could say I'm a dropout. I was briefly studying marine biology, since that's a subject I really enjoy, and was also considering switching to film, but that would have at least required nearly starting over with classes, possibly going to a specialized school for a career that isn't in very high demand. So I stuck with teaching, though honestly, after a while, I really started to lose the passion and motivation I had for wanting to become a teacher. So that's why, when certain situations happened that forced me to take a break from classes, I never went back once I was able to. Like I said, maybe eventually, but for the moment, I'm happy with where I am and what I'm doing. What is the scariest experience of your life? Not a creepy movie or anything like that. I mean a situation where you felt like your life was genuinely threatened. There have been a couple times where I truly feared for my life and thought I would, at the very least, be seriously hurt, and these were the most terrifying because they were caused by other people. I'd rather not go into too much detail for personal reasons right now, but one was several years ago when I was 13, and the other was more recently within the past month. Maybe eventually I'll talk about those in a storytime video, but it's definitely more of a serious subject, so I'll have to think about it. Have you ever hacked on Hypixel or any other server? Well, not exactly hacked per se, but in my very early days of joining the Hypixel server, before I became staff and I was still very new, I did use an X-ray texture pack when playing the walls to help me learn my way around the maps and know where certain resources are. I didn't do it very much, probably for only a small handful of games, and then I found out I could get banned for it, so I stopped. Not exactly my smartest idea to do it in the first place, but yeah, don't cheat, guys. What sports did you play as a kid? I wasn't really a sporty kid, but I did do cheerleading in the 4th and 5th grade, which was pretty fun, but I wasn't really interested in continuing when I got older. In high school, I wanted to do theater instead, so I was very involved in that, sometimes dancing for the musicals, or working as a stagehand, or doing costumes. I pretty much did everything at some points. Was school a pain in the ass? For the most part, no, at least up until college, because I always did fairly well in school for the most part. But once I actually had to start paying to attend classes, it got a lot more difficult. And it wasn't even the work itself that was annoying, but more so because I was going to school for something I wasn't really sure I wanted to do as a career, as I talked about before. Why zombies? Why not skeletons? I got kind of fascinated with zombies in high school after watching Night of the Living Dead in my film class, which is the first ever sort of zombie movie that was made. So it's not exclusively a Minecraft thing. I am somewhat interested in zombies outside of Minecraft. What is the most difficult thing about being a YouTuber? It's definitely keeping content new and fresh for viewers so people are still entertained and keep coming back. I have a habit sometimes that I've even been doing on my channel for the past couple weeks where I'll really get into a game or two and that's all I'll want to post to my channel. But of course, I shouldn't do that because people want more of a variety of content and I should be continuously trying to reach out to a wider audience to grow and expand my channel, but there are some times where I'm like, no, I'm gonna play nothing but Sims this week or Skyrim this week or whatever, so That's something I really need to improve on. What do you think you'd be doing if you never played Hypixel? I'd probably just be working more hours during my day job, since I'm not sure if I would have even started my YouTube channel if I never played Hypixel, so I'm sure my life would probably be a lot more boring, honestly. How did you get your username, and would you ever change it? My username is actually part of my real name, and it originated from years ago, actually, in an online Disney game for those of us fossils who actually remember shows like Kim Possible or Lilo and Stitch. I played a lot of those games back in the day when Disney Channel was actually good, and I got a high score on a game, so I got to put in my name. I put Allie since my first name is Allison, and I'd sometimes go by Allie, but then when I tried to put in my last name too, there was a 7-character limit, I guess. So it said Allie MCC, and I was like, okay, that's close enough, and then that just sort of became my go-to username from then on. As for changing it, I don't think I would unless just the name Allie became available, which is highly unlikely, so I'll probably end up sticking with the name I already have. What motivated you to start YouTube? Well, I already had another channel years ago where I would do music videos with video games or anime clips, and I was actually pretty good at it, and I was doing that for, I think, around 7 or 8 years, and eventually I just wanted to do something different because even though I was fairly good at it, I didn't enjoy doing that as much as I used to. I felt like I didn't really fit in with the community as much as some of the more popular creators, and of course, doing videos like that, there's always constant frustrations with copyright and content being blocked. So I kind of just decided to move into gaming since it was something that still allowed me to make videos and build up an audience, and I really liked doing it, so it just really seemed to fit. Why are you no longer staff? I have a couple videos on that if you'd like to check those out. It is quite a long story and an explanation since it sort of changed over time as new information was available to me, and it would just take way too long to properly explain here. What do you think about the upcoming standalone game? It'll definitely be interesting to see. I don't know much about it since even when I was staff, there wasn't much information that was given to us aside from being completely separate from Minecraft. And of course, it's definitely great to see the network expanding so much that they've gone from making redstone maps to running their own server, eventually becoming the biggest on all of Minecraft, to now developing their own game that they've invested millions of dollars into. So while it could very well be a game that's not quite my style, I have no idea, I don't know anything about it, it'll still be interesting. Who made your Minecraft skin? I did, actually. I think it was either shortly before or shortly after I became mod, and I had a bunch of generic, boring skins up until that point, and I wanted something more unique. And anyone who knows me knows that I'm a huge fan of Disney, so I took an Alice in Wonderland skin and basically zombified it, and that's the skin I've been using to this day. What made you want to become a staff member, and why didn't you resign once you realized what the old staff manager Kay was doing? For the first part, I wanted to become a staff member because I wanted to help out the server, and I was tired of having to take the time to report rule breakers on the forums and wait for them to be dealt with. I wanted to handle things on my own and help make the experience better for people in the community. For the second part, as I've said in a previous video, I didn't know exactly how bad the situation was at the time. I would just make excuses to avoid him, and it usually worked for me. And by the time I realized he was being creepy with a lot of his female staff, he was already removed from the staff team by then. How would you encourage young YouTubers to keep on with what they are doing? Just do what you like and try new things if you find something that isn't working for you or you don't enjoy. If you start doing YouTube with the goal of getting lots of views or making a ton of money, then you're already doing it for the wrong reasons, so just do it for fun. And keep in mind, you aren't going to build an audience overnight. It definitely takes quite a bit of time and a heck of a lot of luck. So if one thing isn't working for you, then just try something new. Experiment with different types of videos and figure out which works best for you. What is your favorite food to eat? This one is super easy to answer. My favorite food is actually the lobster pasta I made for a mukbang video a few months ago. I love pasta and I also love seafood. specifically shellfish like shrimp, lobster, and scallops. So then combining the two is just, it's absolutely fantastic. I've made that recipe a couple more times since I made that video, and it's just, it's so freaking good. After all the horrible experiences you've had, what is keeping you from leaving Hypixel? Even though I've had some issues and negative experiences on the server here and there, at the end of the day, it's still a place where I come to have fun and hang out with my friends. I've met some of my closest friends on the server, and I've spent so much time here. Back when I was staff, I would sometimes skip going to my college classes on some days just to chill on the server, which I definitely shouldn't have done, and I definitely don't recommend anyone do the same thing. Do you like Bob the Builder? I never really liked Bob the Builder, even as a kid, and having to watch it more as a nanny, I've only grown to dislike it even more. But that's probably mostly because the theme song gets stuck in my head all the freaking time when I hear it, and it's so annoying and it frustrates me. What inspires you most to do YouTube? It's mostly just the desire to entertain people and make them happy. I've talked about it before in other videos how views are nice, the money is nice, and I do hope to become a full-time YouTuber eventually, but to see people's days be brightened because of something I create, that's a feeling that I cannot describe just how wonderful it is. Even if I can never make YouTube a career, I'll still be doing it as long as there's at least someone still watching. Why are the forums full of stupid people and the Hypixel community itself is toxic AF? I think it's largely just the majority age group that tends to populate the network. Most players here are around early to mid-teens, and that's around when people tend to think they're such hot shit. They snap easily at the slightest provocation because the hormones are flowing and they just don't know what to do or how to handle certain situations, especially in such a competitive environment. I mean, I wasn't that different when I was that age, so a lot of people just aren't mature yet and don't really know better, so hopefully they'll grow out of it. If you could travel anywhere in the world, where would you go? There's definitely a lot of places I'd be interested in traveling to, like Japan, Germany, France, China, Amsterdam, Scotland, the Caribbean, but I think the place I'd want to visit the most is Italy, just because I've always wanted to go there and the language is really interesting and there's a lot I want to see in the food. Oh, like I said, I love pasta and the food would absolutely be my most favorite part. How do you come up with your song parodies? It usually starts out with coming up with just a line or two pertaining to a specific subject and a certain song. Then I try to write out more lines until eventually it just turns into a full song. Sometimes I'll hit a roadblock and can't think of anything else and I'll have a difficult time finishing it, so unfortunately some don't always get finished, but then there are others that are a breeze to write, so it all just sort of depends. What is your favorite type of music and artist? I can listen to a lot of different types of music, but the sort of music that I go back and listen to on a regular basis is more rock and some metal. My two favorite bands are Paramore and Bring Me the Horizon. I'm constantly going back and forth on which I like better, so I just say both of them are my favorite. But I also like The Killers, Muse, Skillet, Devin Townsend, tons and tons of other artists who I obsess over one or two songs from them here and there. If you had to remove one game mode on the Hypixel network, what would it be? Ranked Skywars, for sure. Because I feel like at this point it does more harm than good. People are already competitive and toxic enough without having this ranking system, and it's such a breeding ground for hackers because people get so obsessed over these points in a freaking Minecraft game and want those rewards so bad that if they aren't good enough or just bored, then they go and cheat and ruin the game for tons of people, thereby making more people frustrated and wanting to cheat and so on. It's the only game that I have not played and probably will never play because I don't care to mess around with all that salt. Too much sodium is bad for you. What is your favorite video that you've made? For right now, my favorite video I've made is my first Hypixel song parody music video called Please Log On. It's my only parody music video that I have released for now, but I love doing videos like that because I enjoy recording games, of course, but these sorts of videos really let me express my creativity and show off more of my skills and what I can do. I like all videos I post, but anything that allows me to be extra creative holds a special place in my heart. Do you like anime? If so, what's your favorite? I do like some anime, though I'm not very well versed in a big variety of anime. My favorite is actually my most recently discovered anime that I started watching a few years ago called Shokugeki no Soma, or Food Wars, because it's the perfect mix of silliness, seriousness, and delicious-looking food porn. If you haven't seen it, then I totally recommend it. What do you think of the current state of Hypixel? Parts of it definitely are not bad. I like all the updates they've been doing, especially on older games and also slowly working on newer games. So developing and content-wise, I think it's been going fairly well. But there's still quite a lot of consistent problems, mainly with the staff, that have been having a negative impact on a lot of players, but I've already ranted about that enough in another video. What do you use to record and edit with? It mostly depends on which game, because I primarily use OBS to record gameplay, but some games just don't get along with OBS, and occasionally I'll have to break out these severely neglected fraps, which is what I previously used before I discovered OBS. I use Audacity to record audio whenever I need to just record audio, and I use a Logitech C920 to record my face cam whenever I do that. For editing, I use Sony Vegas Pro 14, which isn't the best editing software, but it gets the job done, and it suits my needs just fine. What is your Smash Bros. Character of choice? I haven't played the Super Smash Bros. Series since Melee on GameCube, and while I really tried not to stick with the same character every time, I found myself always going back to Zelda, because I really liked a lot of her abilities since she did a lot of magical stuff, and so she could maybe attack from a distance, but she could also transform into Sheik and basically become a ninja, so she was always my favorite. What are your least and most favorite games on Hypixel? Least favorite game that I've played is probably UHC, just because I'm so bad at it, and it's such a long game, so it's an extra waste of time for me. And favorites, other than Build Battle, obviously, would be Walls and Warlords, which is kind of unfortunate since sadly those games tend to not fill up very often. What is your biggest aspiration and how has it changed throughout your life? Right now, my biggest aspiration is to become a full-time YouTuber, to turn what is mostly a hobby that I sometimes get paid for into a career that I can do all day, every day, and be able to pay my bills and support a family with that income. I honestly have no idea if that will ever happen, but it's certainly nice to think about. And of course, that wasn't always my main aspiration. Initially, I just wanted to finish college and get a job as a teacher, but I decided I didn't really want to do that, so I needed something new to set my sights on. Do you like sushi? Depends on what it is. When it comes to sushi, I prefer things that are more simple, like nigiri or sashimi or rolls that don't have a dozen different things in it. If it has too many ingredients stuffed into one roll, then it can be a little overwhelming and it just doesn't taste as good to me. What got you started playing Minecraft and Hypixel? For Minecraft, I got into it how I guess most people do. I just heard about this game that was getting really popular and everyone was having fun with it, so I got it and started playing. And I found Hypixel through a YouTuber that I used to watch, Syndicate, back when he did a lot of Minecraft, and one day he posted a video of a TNT run game, and then I, who had only experienced single player by that point, was absolutely amazed at the sort of things that they were able to accomplish within Minecraft, so I had to try it out, and it just went from there. Do you like frosted sugar cookies? Yes, and anyone who doesn't is clearly a terrible human being. How do I survive on a desert island? Well, I'm not a survival expert, but based on my mediocre knowledge from certain shows on the Discovery Channel, your first priority is finding a source of water that is clean or that you can sterilize by boiling or something. Shelter is also super important to protect yourself from the sun, and only search for food and do a bunch of heavy work only when absolutely necessary, because you should not burn more calories than you're able to take in. Oh, also, if you're on an island, do not rely on coconuts for food. Too much coconut will cause stomach problems and end up hurting you in the long run. The more you know. What's the first video game you remember playing? The original Doom was the first video game that I ever saw. That and Quake. But I remember I was 3 years old and I would sit next to my dad and watch him play for hours. Then he'd sit me on his lap in front of the keyboard and let me play around with the controls in God mode. And eventually I was able to just start playing on my own. Though it didn't exactly thrill my mom to have her toddler be so fascinated by virtual hellspawn being shot up in a rather gruesome fashion, but yeah, that was my introduction to video games. How were your old days of moderation on this server? Is it a good memory you look back on, or is it something you'd like to forget about? For the most part, yeah, it was overall a generally positive experience, met some great people, and learned a lot of things that are still useful to me today. And obviously it wasn't all sunshine and rainbows, especially towards the end, and there were some difficult days, but it was a nice time while it lasted. Where are some of your tattoos? Which was your first, and what made you get them, or what do they mean? Honestly, I have way too many tattoos to name and discuss all of them in one video, but maybe eventually I could do a separate video about it, so let me know if you guys would like to see that. What is your favorite game right now? My favorite game is and has been Skyrim for quite a long time. I mentioned it in my first Q&A a few years ago, and that answer hasn't really changed, especially with the release of Skyrim Special Edition, and I've also gotten into modding the game, and I've even started up a series on my channel of an ultimate modded Skyrim playthrough, so you should definitely check that out because it is very fun. Do you play Pokemon, and what is your favorite Pokemon? I sort of play Pokemon. I collected the cards a long time ago when I was a kid, but never actually got into the games until several years ago when I started playing Heart Gold and Soul Silver, the remakes of Gold and Silver. And of course, I hopped on the Pokemon Go bandwagon when it first launched, though I haven't played as much lately with the newer generations coming out because I don't really like a lot of the Pokemon past generations 3 or 4, but that's just me. Don't hate on me for that. As for my favorite Pokemon, I'm kind of torn between Mew and Celebi because they're both pretty legendary Pokemon, and for me, they're just the perfect mix of badass and completely adorable. How fast can you type? I can type fairly fast. I actually took a minute just now to try out a typing test online and got a result of 65 words per minute, which is pretty good. I took a typing class in high school just because I had an extra slot and didn't know what else to do, but I was one of the few people who actually took the class seriously, so I did really well and it's just kind of stuck. What is your opinion on other controversial Minecraft YouTubers, like Tenebris's exposing videos, Refraction hacking in ranked, Bowspam faking to use vape, shotgun raids being shotgun raids LMAO, and now Time Dio boosting with hackers in the Bed Wars tournament? Alright, well, at the risk of getting a ton of hate from discussing these individuals who each have a much bigger following than I do, I guess we'll go through these one at a time. So starting with Tenebris, I do not have anything against him despite what an oblivious few may think. After I posted a video about a meme he started on the Hypixel forums, despite the fact that I posted literally everywhere that my video was a joke. But anyways, for the most part, I don't think there's anything wrong with the videos he's posting as long as he knows what he's talking about and isn't giving incorrect information or something. But I do think that sometimes he might forget just how big of an audience he has. So if he does something like making fun of a staff member for a dumb comment, that's going to result in a lot of harassment and hate for that staff member. Of course, I understand that a creator can't control what their followers do, and they shouldn't always be held responsible for that sort of stuff. But at the same time, it is also necessary to keep in mind just how much influence you have with such a large audience. So that's all I've got to say about that. With Refraction, it was definitely disappointing to find out he cheated, with him not only being a YouTuber, but a former staff member as well. I think it was in just ranked where he cheated, so it's not like he went on some massive hacking spree or something. And he did at least go on Twitter to express his regret and apologies for his actions. So while personally, I'm conflicted about whether or not he should have gotten a harsher punishment than just a 30-day ban as someone who's more of a public figure and absolutely should have known better, I'm not really upset like a lot of people are that he got unbanned after a month. especially since he did have his YouTube rank removed. So for me, it's like, yeah, he messed up, but he realizes that and seems genuinely sorry, and he's paid his dues, so I can't really be angry at him as long as he doesn't do it again. Then there's Bo Spam. He wasn't quite there to YouTube rank yet, but still had a significant audience at over 25,000 subscribers, I think. But anyways, I did go see the video he posted after his ban, and I wrote an essay in the comments just to give him some much needed advice. To sum up, it was absolutely very stupid to fake using a hacked client on the server, and his reasoning of wanting to be known for something is equally ridiculous. And instead, if he wanted to stand out from other YouTubers, he should have created something unique and original that hasn't been done before. But that being said, a year ban seems a bit too much because of the new automated ban level system and a recent ban he had for something else. I think that's what resulted in such a long ban. And the new punishment system itself is very... I could rant about that for hours, and there's so many problems with it, and a lot of people don't like it, including staff. But getting back on topic, I do have to give Bo credit for acknowledging that he had a severe and continuous lapse in judgment. And I also suggested that he shouldn't essentially put his channel on pause during his ban, since he, as he puts it, wants to stay loyal to Hypixel and only upload videos from the server. And I went on about how restricting your channel can do more harm than good, especially in situations like this, because nobody knows what the state of the server will be in about a year. And since he can't upload much Hypixel content for such a long time, it could very well kill his channel. That's pretty much everything I had to say on the video itself. Aside from that, I think I've seen on Twitter he's been exhibiting some rather toxic behavior recently towards other YouTubers. I haven't looked much into this, so maybe that's how he normally is, I have no idea. But it would definitely not be in his best interest to piss off people even more after this whole vape fiasco. So I hope that he comes to his senses on that eventually. I don't know a lot about shotgun raids, haven't really watched any of his videos, but just from what people have said and what little I've seen, he seems to have completely abandoned Minecraft in favor of Fortnite, which, if he wants to do that, then that's completely fine. But a lot of his videos seem to be copying and even sometimes outright stealing content from smaller YouTubers. Which obviously, if he does do that, it's extremely shitty. But again, I haven't confirmed anything for myself, so I don't know for sure. He's also apparently known to do quite a lot of clickbait, which, depending on the extent, can be frowned upon if he's blatantly lying in thumbnails and video titles about what the actual content is, then yeah, that can be annoying. But for the most part, while I try to avoid it as much as I can myself, I think some mild clickbait isn't really that bad, honestly. Sometimes it can be part of the job as a YouTuber to pull the viewers in and build an audience. Obviously, whatever he's doing is working for him, but I really hope that if he is stealing content, he stops very soon, because not only is that super unfair for the smaller YouTubers that he is stealing from, but it sets a very bad example to his massive audience, many of whom I'm sure are very young and impressionable, and would think that something like that would be totally fine since their idol is doing it, which it's not. It's definitely not okay at all. Now, the situation with Time Dio is the most recent since he was accused of teaming and boosting with hackers in the Bed Wars tournament. I didn't follow this much, so again, I don't know a ton about it and may not have all the information, but I do know that he claimed to not be aware that some of his teammates were hackers. However, he also commented on the video that started all the accusations and said, "Lol, you got me." So first it seems like he denies it and just didn't know his teammates could be potential cheaters, which could be possible. I could maybe be open to believing that. But then it seems like he's almost admitting to it, so I'm not quite sure what to think there. If he did boost with hackers, then that would be very bad as a YouTuber, especially since there have been other accusations of boosting revolving around his guild, though I think it wouldn't be quite as bad if he had done the hacking himself, since he wasn't the one to actively ruin the game for others. He just took advantage of the situation and benefited from it, and again, I don't even know if he actually did intentionally boost or not. All we have is the video that was posted and Time Dio's statements, so you can choose what you want to believe. I personally don't have enough invested in this to look into it more than I already have, since I didn't even participate in the tournament, so I'll leave this one up to you guys. So this took way longer than I expected on just this one question. I probably didn't need to ramble as much as I did, so I'm sorry about that. Let's just move on. Do you still care for Hypixel and the community even though you're not a mod? In a sense, yeah, since I've spent a lot of time here and still have fun and friends here, especially since a large portion of my audience is from the Hypixel community and I always love my subscribers, but I'm certainly not as invested in the community as I used to be when I was staff. What version of Minecraft is your favorite? I'm gonna get some shade for this, but honestly, I really like 1.13 just because of the aquatic update and all the added stuff. Obviously, I'm not really into PvP, so if other people disagree and they're more into combat, that's totally fine. It's just not my thing. So for me, it's exciting to see what new mobs and blocks and other features are being released as new updates come out. Since certain other YouTubers have had problems getting YouTube rank on Hypixel because of past issues, do you think you'll get it when you reach 30,000 subscribers? I honestly have no idea. The requirements say that in order to get YouTube rank with 30,000 subscribers, I need to upload regular Minecraft content, so I don't know if I'll need to wait until I get to 100,000 subscribers, or if once a week would count as regular content. But if it did, then I'd like to think that the staff team wouldn't hold any sort of grudge, since while I have discussed some controversial topics on my channel, I've always tried to do it as respectfully as possible and not mention any names of people I'm talking about and not making videos just to shit talk or rage about anything. So I guess we'll just have to wait and see what happens. Have you ever played a VR game? I have not. Maybe eventually, but I just haven't played any VR games yet. Do you have a pet? Yes, I do. I have my own little doggy Biscuit who has, on occasion, gotten a bit vocal while I'm recording, and I've even shown him on camera a few times on my channel. And we also have a cat named Mindy who belongs to my boyfriend, so with both a dog and a cat here, it gets kind of crazy in our house sometimes. How do you deal with hate you get from your channel? For the most part, I just block it and move on, maybe include it in a reading mean comments video and make them look even dumber than they've already done for themselves. When you start to get some sort of following, I think it's just to be expected that you aren't going to please everyone and that there will be some people that are just so immature and unhappy with their own lives that they feel the need to bring down other people. I'm more than open to constructive criticism and feedback if it's presented politely, like, hey, instead of doing this, I think you should do this or do it this way. That is perfectly fine, and I'm certainly open to discuss what I can do to be better. But comments that are just pure hatred and absolutely vile, I don't need anything like that in my life, and it just doesn't really bother me since I know that people who leave those sorts of comments are just sad and pathetic individuals. Have you ever met K-IRL? Thankfully, no, I never did, though he did certainly try to float the idea of me visiting or even have me stay with him and work for him, like cooking and cleaning for an extended period of time. That was very ugh. Do you want to be a Hypixel moderator again? No, I definitely do not, especially not with the way the current staff team is, particularly the management. I went into more detail about this in another video, so go check that out if you're interested, because it is way too much information to try to cram into this already lengthy video. Do you like Fortnite? Will you ever play it on your channel? I have never played Fortnite. I've watched Ben play it sometimes, and it doesn't seem like a bad game, but I'm not itching to play it on my channel anytime immediately, though I wouldn't rule it out as a possibility for an occasional video in the future. And lastly, the final question, what can we look forward to in the future on your channel? I have so much planned for my channel, and I'm really looking forward to showing you guys what I've been working on. In addition to my normal gameplay videos of both Minecraft and other games, I have some big projects in the works. I have a bunch more parody songs already written that will eventually be recorded and get their own music videos, and I'm always looking for help with that, from vocals to sound editing to participating in the video itself. So if you'd like to help with anything, then please feel free to message me on Twitter or on the Hypixel forums if you have an account there. I also have a new storytime series coming soon, and it's going to be very different from what I've done with my Minecraft and Hypixel storytime videos. It's going to be crazy. from the time I got kicked out of a McDonald's to getting scammed by a guy trying to buy pictures of my feet to my friend getting catfished by someone whose name she had me tattoo on her. I have so many insane stories to tell, and it's going to have a bit of a twist in the videos, so it'll be very special, and I've been working so hard on this, so please tune into that when it's ready. And I also have some secret projects that I can't give too much information about because I want it to be a surprise for you guys, but I'm sure you will love it, and hopefully everything will be coming sometime within the next several months right here on my channel. So thank you guys very much for watching. I don't know exactly how long this video will be after editing, but it has sure been quite a while. So I appreciate you sticking around to the end. If you would like to support my channel and all the amazing projects I have coming out, the link to my Patreon is in the video description, so check that out if you'd like, and subscribe if you haven't already, so you don't miss out on the amazing stuff to come in the future. If you have any questions you'd like me to answer, leave them in the comments and I'll write them down and do another Q&A video sometime later. Thank you guys again for watching, and thank you so much for 6,000 subscribers, and until next time, I will see you guys later. Bye!